At the outset last spring, we're in Delhi, and Delhi is kind of at the edge of Merced County, and it's heavily agricultural. And at the outset, our folks continued working by and large, because they worked in the fields or they worked at foster farms, and as COVID got worse, it got worse for them too. And it got worse for them too because they were still trying to meet the demand of what that kind of initial moment felt like for everybody. And when everybody was like hoarding toilet paper and trying to buy up all the meat they could find and all that kind of good stuff. And in the meantime, our kids, obviously we discovered quickly that our kids very, very much disconnected from their process at school. Distance learning was not necessarily, we kind of got thrown into it. And then moving into the summer, we thought we were going to have some opportunity to have folks on campus and some type of hybrid kind of schedule and things like somewhat back to normal. And then of course, COVID threw us another curveball and that went in a different direction. And we ended up starting the year in distance learning, but with a much more defined plan. That defined plan was great, except now what used to be an opportunity for folks to be engaged and working started to fade off. Outbreaks started to limit the ability for people to be at work. Folks got more afraid, and people started having to be home more. And a lot of our families that were already struggling just fell into a very significant hole that they didn't know how to get out of and that they didn't have resources for. And initially, our outreach to our homeless and foster families and our neediest families beyond those categories really was in the form of food assistance that we had acquired some assistance through UC Merced and a company that was associated with them, an agricultural company, Daylight Foods, that was associated with them. And then had the opportunity to explore assistance with the United Way with Robert. And Robert was able to come up with a plan with me to utilize the Omni cards to provide even greater assistance for folks. And what we've done with that is taken the same group of families. So we service about 25 families per month, and we're able to provide those families with these $250 Visa debit cards. And they in turn give us back the receipts when we come back to them the following month, demonstrating the fact that they're using this stuff on basic necessities, food, utilities, gas, things that they just need for their families to survive. And it's been super successful. People are unbelievably grateful and oftentimes very surprised that the outreach exists. And we've even gone as far this month as to expand it a little bit more and attach some additional families. And families are starting to reach out to the school now because they know that there's some additional help there. And without the United Way support, I don't know how we would be able to help those folks really kind of make ends meet right now. And it's a wonderful thing to be able to provide at least this much assistance to this many families, even though we know that there are other folks in need. But this is a really wonderful outreach.